Now, Sam Ryder, The Pogues, or Wham? Who gets your vote for the Christmas number one? Or maybe you secretly really like that Mariah Carey song. There has been quite the battle this year to take the top spot in the charts, and the result has just been revealed, as Mark Savage reports.
For the first ever time in the history of this song, Wham! And Last Christmas is your official Christmas number one today.
Last Christmas, I gave you my heart, but the very next day, you gave it away.
13 million. That's how many times Last Christmas was streamed over the last 7 days. And that's why it's Christmas number one. For the first time since it was released 39 years ago.
I'm delighted. It has been a long wait in many respects, but it was a song that George wrote with the intention of being a number one, and to finally achieve that goal, it's humbling. Top of the Pile is a great place to be.
What do you think George would make of it going to Christmas number one after all this time?
He'd be absolutely over the moon. He wouldn't have cared for the amount of time it's taken to get there, but you know, better late than never.
Wham's classic fended off a challenge from Eurovision star Sam Ryder, whose song Your Christmas to Me took second place. While Mariah Carey came third. After Shane McGowan's death last month, there had been a campaign to get The Pogues' Fairy Tale of New York to number one. But in a busy week, it had to make do with sixth place. Christmas is the peak sales period for the music industry, and that's why you see records like this back on the shelves and back on the charts every December. And for the artists, it's still an honour to be Christmas number one.
It is the best thing. I keep saying to people, this is basically like my version of a World Cup final. It's my Christmas day. It's that big for us here on the official chart. The Christmas number one, it doesn't get bigger than this.
Outside of the singles race, the Rolling Stones top the albums chart with Hackney Diamonds, a late birthday present for guitarist Keith Richards, who turned 80 on Monday. Mark Savage, BBC News.